Guys, we're back with lecture number 10. I hope you're very, very good. We're gonna pray, okay? So we can put this time in our Lord's hands. God, we put this time in your hands. We thank you for your son. We thank you for our lives, for our families. We hope, Lord, we understand this lecture and we understand that you are the Christ. We thank you in the name of your son. Amen. Okay, guys, so now we're gonna see lecture number 10 that it's called Life of Believing, Life in Faith, okay? So first we're gonna see the covenant. The covenant of works. What was the covenant? The covenant of works. This covenant was the one that we see in Genesis 2, 16, 17. It says that God, when he told Adam and Eve that we couldn't, that they couldn't eat from the tree of knowledge of good and evil. If they ate from that tree, they were gonna die. That was the covenant of works, and Adam broke that covenant, right? So we have this second covenant, that it's the covenant of the Messiah. This covenant has some of characteristics that I'm gonna show you, okay? So this covenant, first, that was that the Messiah was gonna born, right? So we know that he born in Bethlehem, and we know that he was born from a virgin, right? Then the second point is that he was gonna suffer and that he was gonna die. This was the second point of the covenant of the Messiah. The third point of this covenant is that he was gonna resurrect it. Okay, this was fulfilled, okay, on the cross and in the resurrection. This is when he became the Christ, right? When Jesus became the Christ, when he resurrected. After that, we see the Holy Spirit. We see that when Christ went to heaven, he sent us the Holy Spirit, so we can have the Holy Spirit always with us, and he can help us so we can obey the word of God. And after that, that's the final point, or the final characteristic of this covenant, was that the second coming, right? We know that he is gonna come back, right? And all of these points, or these characteristics of this covenant, are fulfilled or are gonna fulfill, okay, in the future. So this covenant, we say pacto in Spanish, it's covenant, it requires obedience, right? We have to obey this covenant of the Messiah. The covenant, for example, of works, it was broken, it didn't have obedience, right? So we have to obey the covenant of God, the covenant that God gives us for us to believe the second coming. So the covenant requires one thing, obedience, right? We have to obey the word of God. We have to obey that Jesus is the Christ. We have to obey his covenant, right? So we can be saved with God, right? So we have the Holy Spirit for what? For us, to help us to obey the word of God, right? And for help us to believe what? That he was the Christ in the cross, on the cross, and in the resurrection, okay? This is how we have to believe in Jesus as the Christ. And now we have to understand that we have to deny ourselves, right? We have to say no to ourselves, to the things I want, to the things I want to become, and be more what God wants me to be. Okay, like for example, I have service at the Friday, right? And at that same time, I have a party. I have to decide what God wants for me. He obviously will want me to go to the church and hear his word that he want to reveal to me, okay? So this is an example. Of course, it is a very awkward example, but it's something so we can understand this part, okay? So when we deny ourselves, we go with the cross, or on the cross with Christ, right? So we suffer with Christ so we can be with him again. And this is how this world, it's denied, and we don't want this world anymore. We don't want the work, the covenant of works, because it was broken. Now we want the covenant of the Messiah, and we believe that he, the Christ, is gonna come back for us if we believe and if we preach his word, okay? So this was the lecture number 9, and we're gonna go to the activity so we can understand more of this lecture, okay? What we are gonna do is we are gonna make 4 drops of blood, and we're gonna put them in red, and we're gonna do two of these two things that we use here, so we can make a little cross over here. One is bigger than the other one, and we're gonna put it in this, like making a cross, and we're gonna also paste them. And as I already said, we are gonna do four of these little drops of blood. And after we have all the materials, we are gonna all paste them in a white sheet so it can look like this. After we paste them, we are gonna put in the two drops of blood that are in our left side, we are gonna write, or we are gonna draw two problems or two scenes that we know or we can relate to, and the other ones are two solutions or two drop of blood that means life, right? And why is this? Because Jesus Christ, through his blood, he cleaned all of our sins and he made them go away, so we can all be with God again without sin, and for our sins to be forgiven. Okay guys, this was our activity. I hope you liked it. You could do it if you want to send us a picture or something so we can see how it turned out. And we're gonna pray so we can close this beautiful lecture. Okay, God, we thank you for this lecture. Thank you because you God put in our hearts the faith of Jesus, whom is the Christ. We wanna have faith in you, in your Son, in your gospel, Lord. Help us so we can understand and believe your word and your covenant, and we can wait for your second coming. Thank you, Lord. We give you in the name of Jesus, whom is the Christ. Amen. Okay, guys. Thank you. See you at the next lecture, that it's called lecture number 11. Bye.